So hi everyone, hi one and all. So next, today we can go and discuss, or I will show you about third ventricle, right? So once we had discussed in the previous classes, this should be the lateral ventricle or the chambers. So this should be the third ventricle. So here we can see the CSF. So once, what I am holding the forceps through here, so this part is most important. This is interventricular foramen or foramen of Monroe. So this will for the communication, or the name indicates interventricular, it has to be connected with the lateral ventricle to third ventricle, right? So this should be the third ventricle. So then I will tell you the parts of the third ventricle. So parts of the third ventricle, mainly you can see this is the anterior wall towards your optic chiasma. This is the anterior wall of the third ventricle. So towards your tectum of the midbrain, you can see the posterior wall of the third ventricle. So this should be the floor of fourth ventricle. This is roof of the fourth ventricle, and along with lateral wall of the third ventricle, right? So this third ventricle has anterior wall, posterior wall, floor, roof, and the lateral wall, right? So first we can discuss within the wall or within the third ventricle, what are the structures has to be present, right? So one, you have to do, take an imaginary line from the interventricular foramen or the foramen of Monroe till your opening of the midbrain posteriorly. This is cerebral aqueduct. So this is the cerebral aqueduct, what I had said. So this is for the connection of third ventricle to fourth ventricle. Lower part, we can see the lower fourth ventricle. So this has to be carries the CSF from here to here. As the name indicate, it is a space, it will carry the liquid called aqua. So it is cerebral aqueduct, because this aqueduct in the cerebrum. So this should be the cerebral aqueduct or aqueduct of Sylvius, and this part will be the chamber of third ventricle. Okay, so take one imaginary line from the interventricular foramen till your cerebral aqueduct. This is called hypothalamic sulcus. Hypothalamic sulcus will be divided into posterior superior part, this should be the thalamus, and anterior inferior part, this should be the hypothalamus. Okay, so this should be the hypothalamus, and this is thalamus. This has to be divided by a sulcus from interventricular foramen to cerebral aqueduct, right? Next, we can come to the anterior wall, roof, posterior wall, and the floor. What are the structure we can make out in the anterior wall? So here in the anterior wall, we can go from above downwards, right? So this above downwards, you can see the body of the fornix. So this should be the fornix. So these are the fibers and the body of the fornix. Just beneath that, you may see a bulby part. This should be called anterior commissure of the third ventricle. This is the anterior wall, anterior commissure, and this should be the fornix. Just lower part, here you can see the lamina. This lamina will be the terminal part. So we can call it as lamina terminalis, or the end part. This lamina terminalis, some of the authors says this should be the end part or the cranial part of the neural tube. Okay, this should be the lamina terminalis. So from above downwards, don't confuse. So this should be the body of the fornix, anterior commissure, lamina terminalis, and this should be the optic chiasma, right? You all of you saw the base of the brain. This should be the optic chiasma. Okay, this is lamina terminalis, anterior commissure, and fornix, right? This is form anterior wall of the third ventricle. Okay, then we may go to the floor of the third ventricle. So this floor of the third ventricle will be continuation from the optic chiasma. This should be the optic chiasma, then optic tract. We can see this optic chiasma. Just behind that, we may see the tuber cinereum. So this part is tuber cinereum. Behind that, we may see the mammillary body. So this is the body, rounded body. This is mammillary body. So this is tegmentum of midbrain. So this is the part called tegmentum of the midbrain, because cerebral aqueduct will be divided into tegmentum and the tectum. So this part will be the tegmentum and cerebral aqueduct. Okay, once again, from medial to or anterior to posterior, we may see the optic chiasma, tuber cinereum, mammillary body, and tegmentum of midbrain. Okay, next, coming to the posterior wall of the third ventricle. from above downwards. Same over here. Here you may see the fornix fibers, and lower part here you may see the posterior commissure. What I am showing now, this should be the posterior commissure, and behind that you may see the pineal body over here, pineal body, and lower part you may see the thalamus. So this is posterior part of the thalamus. It is also called pulvinar of the thalamus. Here you may see the two bodies, lateral geniculate body and the medial geniculate body, and this will be for the supraoptic rhesus and pineal rhesus, pineal body, posterior part of the thalamus. Then it will be continuation will be the lower part as tectum of the midbrain. So this should be the posterior wall. Once again, supraoptic rhesus, pineal body and pineal rhesus, then should be tectum of the midbrain. So understood. So this should be the posterior wall, this should be the anterior wall, this is the floor, and this is the roof. Roof is formed by mainly the fibers of fornix, fibers of the fornix and the body of the fornix. Just beneath the fibers or the fornix, you may see one more foramen, what I had said before. So this is interventricular foramen or foramen of Monroe. So through your sulcus, that is through the cerebral aqueduct, it will form one sulcus that is called hypothalamic sulcus. So this part is thalamus, this is hypothalamus. So along with what I had said, supraoptic nucleus, preoptic nucleus, those are all has to be interconnected to your thalamus. Then we can discuss at the one more class for the hypothalamus. So this is hypothalamus, this is thalamus, this should be hypothalamic sulcus. Next is anterior wall, floor, posterior wall, and the roof of the third ventricle along with the chamber or the lateral wall of the third ventricle. Thank you.